everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is December 4th. It is Thursday, and today we're going to answer your questions. We had a great call last night with Dr. Jason Deitch. It was really fun. We talked about the healthcare industry, and he brought up some very interesting points about how we as healthcare practitioners, providers, journalists, whatever you want to call it, how we can build a team where we all are working together instead of working in opposition with each other. And I hear so much of it where there are practitioners who just completely, you know, attack someone else, and it's just so, absolutely, it's so unnecessary. You know, we all have something of value, and we all provide different value to different people. And so, you know, now, of course, there are some people who are uneducated and who are providing fallacious information, and that's no good. But attacking is really not the way we should be doing those. So anyway, attacking. Anyway, I've got a bunch of questions here. I want to run through them. I have a question. This is from yesterday. The recipe says to soak overnight and blanch the almonds. I don't know where blanch came from. Anne-Marie wrote it down. I have no idea. We didn't blanch the almonds. Blanching them is just dropping them in boiled water. So I don't know why Anne-Marie put blanched. So we can ask her. But we didn't blanch them. We just peeled off the skin on them. So no, you don't blanch them. All right. Why do you never mention lohan for use as a sweetener, which is a Chinese fruit? Because we don't use it. That's all. I've never used lohan. I'm sure I don't know enough about it to tell you yes or no. I mean, when we look at all these like exotic type things, and you know, lohan isn't that exotic. It's exotic to the U.S. You know, I mean, you can't go around and you know, search out sweeteners. Why not just use fruit? And not even a fruit powder, just use real fruit as a sweetener. That's it. Just real fruit. So good. So anyway, that's what we don't use lohan. And again, we were just talking on the Inner Circle call. The thing about sweeteners for us is, you know, we do the prep, you know, every Wednesday, and sometimes we do desserts. Those desserts sit in our freezer. Literally, they sit in there. Hold on, I'll show you. Remember the Snickers bars that we made? Guys, they're still here. They're still here in the freezer. Anne-Marie had a birthday cake. I don't know if you remember that. I don't know if we showed that little video. But look, there's still pieces left. We don't eat this stuff. One of the main reasons we do the desserts is because, one, it's a great way to introduce people to raw food through desserts, because it's something that's sweet and something that you can associate very closely to what you're used to. And two, because sometimes it's fun to do a little bit of dessert, but we don't eat the stuff. It stays in there. So that's kind of my spiel on desserts, on sweeteners and all that sort of stuff. Fruit sugars are great. All right, can you clarify on which honey you're talking about? I'm guessing the honey I buy at the grocery store is not it. You're looking for raw honey. And the stuff that you find in the bear, or the stuff that's very clear that you can kind of see through, that's not going to be the honey that you're looking for. That's processed. You want to look for raw honey. It's almost... It's not transparent. You can't see through it. I wouldn't say opaque, because that means no light goes through. But it's almost a whitish kind of golden color, instead of a very gold type color that the processed honey is. And if you look into it, you can see sometimes it separates, and it's very. Oh, I'm just struggling with this right now. I can't describe honey. I can't describe raw honey. Oh, it has stuff in it. It has bee pollen, and it has stuff in it. If it's a really, really fresh and raw honey. So that's all I'm going to say about that one. Man, I'm struggling today. Some days you have it, some days you don't. Today's one of those days where I'm like, eh. Next up, curious, would you consider Ezekiel bread, frozen bread you buy at the health food store, based on whole sprouted grains, a whole food? Would I consider that a whole food? It's closer to a whole food than, say, Wonder Bread. So it's a step. It is made from sprouted grains. It's baked. That's fine. I would consider Mono Bread closer to the whole food. Probably be a better bread for you. Mono Bread, you can find that frozen at the grocery store as well. And that's heated at a lower temperature than the Ezekiel Bread. The Ezekiel Bread, I think, is fired. And this is heated at a much lower bread. You can also make a dehydrated bread in the dehydrator, and you can use a bunch of grains, put them all together, and put it in the dehydrator. Eventually, we'll do something like that, and show you how you can do that. Another question. My question is, fresh coconut sold in the supermarket, is it chemically treated? Good question. Here's the deal. A lot of people have said that these young Thai coconuts are treated with formaldehyde. Matt Emson did a study where he actually tested them and they turned up no formaldehyde, but he didn't test any other chemicals. So we know that the ones that he tested don't have formaldehyde, but they may have other chemicals. They probably have pesticides if you're eating them from a regular supermarket. I'm sure that they're sprayed. There's some sort of mold or fungicide that they use for some of these, because when they're shipped over from Thailand, literally can take 4 to 6 weeks, and they can get very very fuzzy, if you will. So anyway, that's going to be it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. I do want to mention one thing. We had our Thursday Inner Circle chat today. It was really fun. We had a bunch of people there. I don't remember the number of people who were there, but there's a lot of people in the Inner Circle chat. I would like you to join us for one of those. If you're not a member of the Inner Circle, we have a 30-day free trial. What the Inner Circle does is it provides you with some great information that allows you to get your questions answered by us and by the Inner Circle community. There's a lot of people in there, and a lot of them are really smart. It allows you to get access to all the downloads for all our calls. It allows you to come in and hang out with us on Thursdays, which is kind of fun. We have a lot of fun with that. We had some fun today. And it also allows you to get discounts on any sort of products that we come out with in the future. So that's really cool. There's a lot of value there, and it's after the 30-day free trial, it's only $9.97 a month, which is very, very reasonable. Consider it like a continuing education for your health. There are some programs out there where you get to hear different speakers speak about health, and there's different educational programs where they bring speakers in and all that sort of stuff. This is $9.97 a month. Those are much more expensive. You get the same stuff, and you get to ask your questions. So, I don't know. I think there's some value in that, don't you? Anyway, what you can do is right now, if you want, you can get a 30-day free trial. You post it down. I post it down below. Down below, I have there's a link. It's renegaderoundtable.com/IC. So IC. And you can go and check that out. And the other thing is that your membership actually helps support what we're doing here. So it does help with the Renegade Health Show. It supports this show here. And it allows us to continue to do this with a team of web designer, a team of booking, a team of people who handle your customer support and all this too. Otherwise, we would not be able to do all this sort of stuff, and we would just be the small guy in the corner, not really making any waves, and that's not what I'm going to settle for. So, with your help, we can make this all happen. RenegadeRoundtable.com/IC, that's the Inner Circle, a 30-day free trial. Please come and join us and have some fun, introduce yourself, and that's going to be it for today. Your question of the day is this: how often do you eat desserts? Just want to know. How often are you eating sweets? I'd like to know. I eat sweets. I haven't eaten sweets in almost 3 months now. But how often do we eat sweets? Usually, maybe once every 2 weeks. Probably about it. So go ahead and post that down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.